God and clearly please.
The rich rule under the Lord, and the power of the servant to the lender.
Okay. Power is servant to the lender. So, don't borrow. Don't loan the money to your close friends or to your family members. You go, wait a minute, then where can I borrow money? Right? Bank! That's right. You see, if a bank do not loan you money, that means you have no authority or no place, or what do you say? You have no nothing to spend the money.
Collateral.
Huh? You know, somebody told me, you know, it is good to help each other. And because you are close friends, you know how much they have, you know how much this person is in trouble, because when you are very close, right? And you have a tendency to try to help, and you have a tendency to ask for help in family members. But do not. Why? Money is evil. Money breaks those relationships. And you think it's all gonna be, you know, work out, it's out of good heart. But something will happen, and you loan the money, you borrow the money in intention to return it, right? Intention to collect it back. When you cannot, then you ruin the relationship. The friends never gonna be your friends anymore. Family members never gonna be, because Bible says what? Borrower is slave to lender. And how can you have a relationship? It's unequal. You cannot have a relationship. So what do you do when your sister needs, I know my sister, I know my brother, I know my parents, I know my kids, they need $20,000. They want to borrow. I have $20,000. What would you do? Somebody got to shout it. Huh?
Just say no.
Just say no. But you want to help them.
But it says right here.
Just say no. Okay, who else?
Give it to them.
Amen. Hallelujah. Give it to them. You said, you crazy? $20,000, no can give. No can give, no can loan. Got it? No can give, you cannot afford to give $20,000 to your sister, your brother, or whoever, your close friends, that means you cannot loan them either. Got it?
Got it.
Have you seen Judge Judy? Boy, I often wonder why on earth grandpa brings grandson to the court for lousy $3,000. You know, it's a principle. Grandpa's feeling got hurt. You know, when they try to borrow money, they are so nice, and grandpa, I will give you back as soon as I get a job, and this and that. And then he got a job, and then he had a girlfriend, and spent it all. You know, the borrowers, they spend the money like they have a fortune saved in somewhere. You know, lenders, they don't spend money. They save. That's why they have money. And borrowers, hello, money grows on trees, that's what my, you think money, yeah. So, don't let me go on and on and about this. This is a principle. So when your brother cries over your shoulder, and you contemplate, you pray to God, how much can I give it to him? You really want to help. And also, when you really, really need $20,000 to borrow, go to bank. If bank doesn't loan you, you pray to God.
Yes.
Then God's going to move those hearts to give you $20,000, and you will have a great relationship with that person. Got it? Huh?
I was thinking of verse 36, Jan, I was full. Before the Lord, that the verse is Matthew.
All right.
36, Jan, I
okay. And two do's. Number four. Let's read verses, chapter 25. Is it? 25, 17?
Okay.
Sell the
food in your neighbor's house. Too much on you.
I like this passage. It's so clear. You don't have to go through it, right? Sell the food in your neighbor's house. Too much of you. They'll hate you. And what they say? Do not overextend your welcome. Yeah, we all know that, right? And then we weren't sure that we are overextending or not, so you ask. All right, don't ask. If you ask, what are they going to say? Yes or no, right? When they say no in your face, you get hurt. And it puts a damper on your relationship, right? And when they say yes, it's not weird, and they get hurt. And the next time you want to go visit them, they're going to give you a laundry list of why they cannot have you back. Do you want that? No. You know? So I don't want to call it. Baseball. What's the difference between the home run and, well, what is that? Strikeout or second base? What's the difference between that? Huh?
Home run, you score.
Yeah, home run, you score. Who makes the home runs? Someone who
bets
on right time. Timing, isn't it? Timing. Timing is very important in hitting anything. Great shots. Timing is very important.
Yes.
Also, timing is very important in your relationships. Timing is very important in your relationships. You know what I'm saying? Some of us have lousy timing. Always calls you, always knock on your door when you are not really ready. You are in meditation, or in the shower, or eating mouthful of food, or your hands are so dirty, or garbage disposal going on. They call you, and then you don't answer, they get upset. I know so-and-so is home. Why? He's avoiding my call. I knock on the door. I knew he was at home, but do not answer. It's a timing,
yes,
you know?
Yes, you get timing.
I want to confess. My husband has a lousy timing. Every time phone rings in middle of my meditation, I know it's him. Often, 90 times, 90%. Because early in the morning or late in the evening, except emergency phone calls, you are so good in timing. Only my husband. You know, and so I accuse him have a lousy timing. One time I had a lousy timing.